Over the past few years, I've been to many different amusement parks, and in all of them, I like to buy the meal plan to save some money and enjoy the park food. Kings Island, out of all of the parks I've visited, has some of the best food options, especially for the all-season dining plan. Their restaurants are far superior to most other Cedar Fair parks, much better than all other Six Flags parks, and are very much close, if not better, than the Busch Gardens parks. So today, I'm talking to you guys about the top 10 places to eat on the dining plan in Kings Island. Let's get into it. Number 10, Hank's Mexican Grill. This place is definitely not my favorite, but it does come in here at number 10, just because there's not that many restaurants to put at Kings Island. Some people tend to like it. If you don't know, it's pretty much Chipotle, Qdoba, all those ones, just the ripoff of it at Kings Island. In my opinion, the food is pretty much less quality, but it is decent food. I guess if you're over there, you might want to get it. Personally, I just got it once and I won't get it again because there are many other great food choices in that same area. But Hank's Mexican Grill is not terrible and is honestly better than you'll get at most Cedar Fair parks. Number 9, Skyline Chili. Most people from the Midwest will probably know what this is and not even have to go to Kings Island to know what Skyline is. But I'm not from the Midwest. When I went to Kings Island, trying Skyline was the first time I ever had it, and it was pretty good. It doesn't live up to the hype that some Ohioans give it, but it's not that bad, and it's also a good spot to get for food. I think that in that same area that it is in, though, there are many other great places to get food at. I think there's two in the park, and in both spots you can get other great options right near it. So not necessarily the best option, but once again, it's an Ohio favorite. Gotta try it at least once. Number 8, La Rosa's, the pizzeria Italian place. This I've only gotten once as well, and I didn't find it too great. There's not a lot of great Italian places in amusement parks, but this one is really no exception. The Rosa's is okay, and it does usually have a long line, so I guess the GP is pretty popular and pretty much a fan of it, but the pizza was decent, the breadsticks were okay, and I just didn't really love it, so that's why it's here at number 8. Number 7, Tom and Chi, the grilled cheese place. This place is rated really highly depending on some of the rankings that you'll see online. People talk about this place very highly. I personally don't think it's that great. It's just one of those spots where you can get it outside the park. It's really not overly amazing and doesn't blow me away, but it is a good spot. You gotta try it at least once. And I think this is the last kind of place here that you cut off the tier of just going there once and trying it out. Number 6, Chick-fil-A. I don't even know that I need to say anything for Chick-fil-A, but make sure you go to Chick-fil-A on Sundays. As everyone knows, Chick-fil-A is the best on Sundays. Number 5 is Jukebox Diner. So this is one of the better places to eat in the park, and I think it's really good. It's an older restaurant. It's not like brand new or anything. It has a really cool environment and theme to it. It's just a place where you should go to. Like, you have to go there more than once. This is one of the places that I will look forward to going to when I go to Kings Island and to the park. I like the grilled chicken sandwich a lot. The burger is also pretty good. It's not the best burger in the park, but it is the second best burger in the park, if that means anything. It just has a really great theme, really great feel to it, and has some great food. Number 4, Potato Works. Potato Works has those loaded fries. I personally like the buffalo chicken loaded fries. Those are really good. Obviously not the healthiest spot if you want to lose weight, probably not the spot to go to, but that's not what we're talking about here. But Potato Works has amazing fries. This is one of the most loved spots at Kings Island. It's always got a line. It's a very small spot, of course, right there next to the Beast and Mystic, and it's just a really good spot. I'm glad they have it on the meal plan. I go to it probably once every 3 times I go to the park, I'd say, and of course you get like 2 meals per visit, so I go there a decent amount, and I definitely look forward to getting this place. Number 3 is Coney Barbecue. This place is absolutely great. Personally, my favorite thing to get here is the rotisserie chicken. If they have the baked sweet potato, would highly recommend that. But outside of that, I also do like the mac and cheese on the side, but it's pretty much the same mac and cheese you'll get anywhere else. This place is really good. One thing that you definitely like want to like about this is that it doesn't really have a long line. They get people out of that place fast. So this is one of those places, if you're there on a busy, hot Saturday, this is probably one of your go-tos because there's not that long of a line usually. And while places like Jukebox or Chicken Shack and have a line out the door and like a 20-30 minute wait, this has got like a 5 minute line and it's AC. Really nice place to go to with some great food. Number two, Chicken Shack. No surprise here, my favorite thing to get is the chicken wings, and they got some very good chicken wings. I think that this place is just about equal to Coney Barbecue in my opinion. It just usually has a longer line, so I do end up going to Coney Barbecue a little more. But Chicken Shack is most people's favorite place that I talk to in the park. It's just an amazing place to go. Always has a long line. There's always people there, and there it's for a good reason. They have some of the best wings, some of the best chicken I've ever had in an amusement park. I mean, their chicken tenders are far above like a Six Flags chicken tender, and that's why people pay so much more for the Kings Island dining plan than they would for the Six Flags dining plan. And Chicken Shack is one of the go-to places at the park. Absolutely love it. The wings are great. Number one, Miami River Brewhouse. If you watch my channel, this is no surprise. Miami River Brewhouse is by far the best place to eat at Kings Island. This right here, mark my words, is the best food I've ever had at an amusement park. I haven't been to Dollywood yet, so I know they have some good food there. I'll give you that. I haven't been to every park out there, but this right here, this restaurant alone, is the best restaurant I've ever been to at any park. The burgers are absolutely phenomenal. Just blew me away when I went to it. I love the service there. Always has a line for a good reason. It's just really great food. Love how you sit down. It feels like you're leaving an amusement park and going to a sit-down restaurant. This is like you have to go to this. I'm probably there. I try to get there on every visit, but of course it doesn't end up happening that way. But I'd say I'm there probably like 75% of my visits for one of my meals. This place is just awesome. I can talk about it all day, but this really just shows to you how great Kings Island's food is and why Kings Island's park atmosphere can be benefited so much just by adding food places like this. The reason I'm talking about this is because I feel like it differentiates Kings Island from other parks like Cedar Point. Kings Island, honestly, doesn't have that great of a ride lineup. I'm sorry. It has an amazing ride lineup, but not a better coaster lineup than Cedar Point, even Six Flags Magic Mountain. But what it does have is a great park atmosphere, and that's why people rank it above the Six Flags Magic Mountains and sometimes the Cedar Points. This food right here contributes to that, and that's why I feel like I had to rank the best place to eat at Kings Island. But with that being said, that's going to do it for today's video. Thank you guys for watching. Be sure to let me know in the comment section what you guys thought and what your favorite places to eat are at Kings Island. I'll see you guys next time.